Hi, I'm Chef David Jahnke, and today I want to show you a recipe with one of my favorite wild picked mushrooms, which is Amanita Calyptrata. Beautiful, tender, soft, almost like an egg yolk texture, flavor, and well, just look at the size of them. They can get very large and big, and well, let me show you how I found them actually, so you can see how they look in the wild. So take a look at those beautiful large mushrooms here, about the size of my hand. Beautiful, and those are... Back from the forest, we cut off our beautiful large size Amanita Calyptrata mushrooms. They're beautiful. Mushrooms always have like three textures, no? They have the gills in that case. Sometimes they have also like a spongy. On the top, we have like that skin, which is actually pretty solid and well, it gives us a different, tougher texture on the up part. And also the meat section here, it's different. It's almost like a chicken breast, no? The gills, they are like individual. You can see, and they also have, of course, a different texture than the top part. Also, the stalk is different. No, the stalk actually it's full of meat, and here we can see like that egg shape, because this mushroom comes out like kind of from the egg, like an egg shape when it come out. They pop off and then open up, and then also like the head opens up. No, beautiful mushroom, and like it's one of my favorite actually. They have like a very nice flavor, and the recipe I want to show today. It's a bit different. That's like my own recipe here, but it's very simple and easy to reply. Basically, I would try to reinvent the forest a little bit, and for that dish I'm just going to use actually the stalk of that mushroom. You can also use other mushroom stalks for that, of course. And well, beside that, I'm going to make a pesto for it. The pesto for that, we are having some pecorini or parmesan cheese, fresh grated. I have two varieties of basil here, olive oil, some pine nuts, which I will roast a little bit dry, some pepper, some sea salt, Himalaya salt, a little bit of garlic. That's why I make the pesto base sauce. I got some flowers to decorate from the basil, purple basil and green basil, but we also want to get flavor to the stock first. Oh well, that's like the main thing, and then we're gonna use some other things to decorate. So to the stock, we are going to saute some bacon, which I've cut in slices, in some butter with some garlic and a little bit of shallots. And then we're gonna all saute in olive oil. We're gonna add some Himalaya salt, and then we're gonna add the stock to it. We're gonna cook it very quick. We don't wanna give it too much time, but we're gonna like 2-3 minutes until it's nice tender cooked. And then we're gonna build the dish and make the presentation with the pesto and the flowers we have here. That's the dish I want to make today. Thank you very much for watching my video. I hope you liked it, and if yes, then please subscribe to my channel or give me a like to the video. I'm Chef David Jahnke. Hasta pronto.